Good morning, everyone. So as you know that we are starting this chapter.
India after independence.
Okay, so till now what we have studied? We have studied that what were the different challenges that new and dividing nation had to face. And then I told you the important key features of the Indian constitution, then how states were formed, and planning development. What kind of planning that India should have so that the industries would be developed and the India could have a strong industrial base. Because it is not like that the country had to solely depend on the agriculture sector. So for more development, there should have been a technical and modern base was also required. Okay. Then after that, today we are going to start with the topic. The nation 60 years on. Okay, so this is the last topic of the chapter. So we'll try to conclude it. Before that, there is little on page 170, the search for independent foreign policy. What is there? Little bit I will tell you about that. So what happens? See, India gained freedom soon after the devastations of the Second World War. Okay, Second World War, when it happened?
1939.
Yes, 1939 to 45. And when did First World War happen? 1914 to 1918. I think these dates you should know. Then what happened? This United Nations were formed. When was United Nations formed? Underline this line. The United Nations formed in 1945. Underline this line. So it was formed in 1945. And what happened that time? You know that there were different countries which were involved in World War II. So USA and USSR, which is today known as
Russia.
So that time it was Soviet Union, USSR. So they were trying to gather more and more countries toward their side. अपने साथ में और countries को मिला रहे थे. So when any country got independence, that time they both were trying to convince that country to come and join them, because they were both having. They both were powerful countries. So they were trying to make their own team as a big team. Okay? But what happened that time? So you know when India got independence, so these both countries across India. So India ko bola ki aap hamare team mein aa jao, and USA said ki aap hamare team mein aa jao. But India did not take any team. So that then what happened? So that was known as independent foreign policy. What is the independent foreign policy? Jawaharlal Nehru did not believe in going into any team. He said that we India, we will make as independent foreign policy. It's written here. So this was also the period when colonial empires were collapsing. That time, why were colonial powers collapsing? China ho gaya and Russia, so when they were already under British rule first of all. So when they were getting freedom and USA, Germany, they were in World War II. So they were already weak that time, even Britishers were weak because so many things had been, they have lost in the world wars. So that had made them weak. So that's why they left India also. India bhi ko tabhi chhoda tha because they were weak now. So they gave up and they left. So then what happened? Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, who was also the foreign ministry of newly independent India, developed free India's foreign policy in this context, and non-alignment was formed. So why we said? Because why Jawaharlal Nehru did not take anybody's team? Unhone na USA ko join kiya na USSR ko join kiya. Why? Because these two nations, they were powerful, but there were ideological conflicts between them. They were always, you can say, fighting between them. So if Jawaharlal Nehru believed in non-violence, he said that we will not fight with any nation. We will only make our nation strong. कि हमें अपना nation strong बनाना है, हमें किसी के साथ नहीं लड़ना है. So that's why India was neutral that time. So then Jawaharlal Nehru said we will not join anybody's team. Because अगर USA को join करेंगे तो USSR will feel bad, and if they will join USSR then USA will feel bad. So that's why we did not join anybody's team, and India had independent foreign policy. And this was liked by other countries also. जब और ज़्यादा countries independent See, it's written here. Countries who played an active role between American and Soviet Unions, they tried to prevent war. So what we did, India and other countries who were joining India and we were adopting this independent foreign policy of non-alignment. So we did this to prevent war and often taking a humanitarian and moral stand against war. Because we did not believe in war, we believe in peace. However, for one reason or another, many non-aligned countries, including India, got involved in wars. So but that time, कुछ ना कुछ होता रहता था, कॉन्फ्लिक्ट चलते रहते थे, सो दे कुड नॉट यू कैन से रेजिस्ट दैट टाइम. सो देन व्हाट हैपेंड, द नेशन 60 इयर्स ऑन, सो यू नो दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड इन दिस चैप्टर, हमने कितना कुछ पढ़ा, दैट व्हाट इंडिया फेस चैलेंजेस, दैट व्हाट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वाज रिटन. सो डू यू थिंक दैट आफ्टर सम इयर्स, जैसे अबाउट 2007, सो 2007 तक, सो वाज इंडिया एबल टू स्टैंड इटसेल्फ? You think so? Was it completely or was it not at all? Still, India is a developing country. So it is a developing country. You cannot say that we have attained complete failure. No, you can say it is still developing. And what happens? See, they have written on 15th August 2007, India celebrated 60 years of its existence as a nation. So what happened? So how well has the country done in this time, and to what extent has it fulfilled the ideals set out in its constitution? So what is there? See, if you see India, it is still united. Yes. It is still united, and still we have democracy. Yes. Okay, that the power is for the people, by the people. So for achievements, because that time some foreign countries observed, so which foreign countries thi, unko kya laga that India could not stand on its own and it will come under military rule. Because when India got independence, you know that India was not that strong. India was not that strong, so that's why foreign countries, they observed that India will not be able to stand itself. So it's written here, many foreign observers had felt that India could not survive as a single country, that it would break up into many parts with each region or linguistic group seeking to form a nation of its own. Because you know that India is a diverse country, it is a alag alag rule rehte hain, alag alag bhasha hote hain. So they believe that all the people of different region, they cannot live together. So ultimately there will be demand of the different states and different nations. However, but if we compare, however, how many general elections have been done till now?
13.
Kitni general elections ho gayi hain? As many as 13 general elections have been held since independence. This is the data of 2007. But if you take up to now 2019, then kitni general elections ho gayi hain? 19. Okay, write down. The 19 general, no, not 19, 17. 17 general elections have been held till 2019, and hundreds of states and local elections hoti rehti hain. There is a free press, independent judiciary, and finally the people speak different languages or practice different faiths has not come in the way of national unity. So still we have national unity is there, that people, though they are speaking different languages, alag alag tarah ke log hain, but still something is there which is binding us. Okay, still we are united. But on the other hand, there is a negative picture also. So this is a positive picture, that we have had so many elections till now, we are still united, there is a free press, there is independent judiciary. But on the other hand, there are deep divisions. Because we have seen that people fighting in the name of religion, still they fight. ठीक है, अभी भी होती है. सो डिस्पाइट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल गारंटीज अनटचेबल, सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट अनटचेबल्स, स्टिल इन द वेरी यू कैन से इंटीरियर पार्ट्स ऑफ ओडिशा एंड बिहार, स्टिल दिस थिंग इज सीन दैट अनटचेबल्स आर देयर एंड देयर द क्वालिटीज आर स्टिल नॉट डेवलप्ड एंड स्टिल दे आर नॉट अलाउड टू एंटर इनटू टेंपल्स, होली प्लेसेस में अभी भी उनको अलाउ नहीं करते हैं. सो स्टिल यू कैन सी दैट दो India has got independence and we have developed enough, but still you can say that there are so many things which still needs to be paid attention. Okay, so untouchables are still, it's written here that untouchables, they are now referred to as Dalits, face violence and discrimination. Ki abhi bhi वो वायलेंस फेस करते हैं, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन फेस करते हैं. इन मेनी पार्ट्स ऑफ रूरल इंडिया दे आर नॉट अलाउड एक्सेस टू वाटर रिसोर्सेज. ठीक है, अभी भी कुछ ऐसे पार्ट्स हैं इंडिया में जहाँ पे मीन्स इफ दे आर कॉमन सोर्स, पानी का जो कॉमन वाटर सोर्स होता है वहाँ से अनटचेबल्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू टेक वाटर फ्रॉम देयर. एंड टेम्पल्स पास में उनको नहीं जाने दिया जाता है. एंड डिस्पाइट द सेक्युलर आइडियल्स एनश्राइंड इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन देयर हैव बीन क्लैशेस बिटवीन डिफरेंट रिलीजियस. कि अभी भी लोग धर्म के नाम पे क्या करते हैं, लड़ते हैं. यस, सो अबव ऑल यू कैन सी द गल्फ बिटवीन द रिच एंड पुअर हैज ग्रोन ओवर द इयर्स. गल्फ, व्हाट इज गल्फ? गल्फ इज गैप. द गैप बिटवीन द रिच एंड पुअर इज सो बिग. सो यू कैन इमेजिन दैट एट वन पॉइंट देयर इज अ स्मॉल रिच पर्सन एंड ही इज नॉट इवन गेटिंग इनफ फूड टू ईट. ठीक है, उसके पास बिल्कुल खाने के लिए पैसा नहीं है. एंड यू कैन इमेजिन अ वेरी रिच एफ्लुएंट फैमिली, दोज़ हु आर डाइनिंग इन अ रेस्टोरेंट. वो एक टाइम पे होटल में जब खाने जाते हैं सो दे आर स्पेंडिंग 5 to 10,000 देयर ऑन वन मील. एंड इफ यू कंपेयर दैट 5 to 10,000 द सेम पुअर पर्सन इज गेटिंग द राशन फॉर होल मंथ फ्रॉम दैट 5 to 10,000. So that much you can say gap is there. This is the gap still between rich and poor. Some parts of India and some groups of Indians have benefited a great deal from economic development. They live in large houses and dine in expensive restaurants. So if you see at one side ki kai log itne bade bade gharon mein rehte hain, itne restaurants mein jaate hain, send their children to expensive private schools and take expensive foreign holidays. At the same time, many others continue to live below poverty line. Housed in urban slums or living in remote villages that yield little, they cannot afford to send their children to school. So still these kind of discriminations are there. This gulf between the rich and poor is still there in the society. And the constitution says that there is equality before law. So do you think this is also applicable? Equality before law, it's still applicable everywhere?
No.
No. Because still we can see that there is a discrimination between the rich and poor. Okay, so this is also not completely being followed. So real life Indians are more equal than others. So you can see the last line is the conclusion of the chapter that at independence, the Republic of India has not been a great success. The constitution of India ka hai. जिसमें इक्वेलिटी है एंड अनटचेबल्स को अबॉलिश किया है. सो यू कैन से दैट इट हैज नॉट बीन अ ग्रेट सक्सेस बिकॉज वी स्टिल फील दैट देयर इज स्टिल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन द सोसाइटी बट इट हैज नॉट बीन अ फेलियर. ठीक है, बट ऐसा भी नहीं बोल सकते हैं कि बिल्कुल भी डेवलपमेंट नहीं हुई है इंडिया की. सो इफ यू कंपेयर द इंडिया ऑफ टुडे टू द इंडिया ऑफ दैट टाइम यू कैन सी द चेंज. नो, सो वी कैन नॉट डिनाई इवन दैट देयर आर नो डेवलपमेंट्स. So there is not even failure or not even complete success is there. Okay, so this was there in this chapter. Now come to the back exercise quickly. Before that there is one paragraph which you can read yourself what happened in Sri Lanka. Because you know Sri Lanka is part of India or not? No. So what happened that time? Mahapipi, same thing was the issue of language was there. So what is the language that is spoken in Sri Lanka and what was the old name of Sri Lanka? Ceylon. Okay, it's written here that Sri Lanka, then Ceylon, and there this language was there, Sinhala. Sinhala was the language there, but there were Tamil speaking communities were also there. So there was also conflict, or maybe conflict hota tha ki they are speaking Tamil and Sinhala was being imposed on them. So you know कि अगर कोई लैंग्वेज किसी पे हम इम्पोज करते हैं सो देन द अदर कम्युनिटी फील्स उनको क्या लगता है दैट वी आर नॉट एबल टू एक्सप्रेस आवरसेल्व्स दैट दे आर अंडर एस्टिमेटिंग अस. सो सेम थिंग हैपेंड देयर आल्सो देयर वर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स एंड दिस बिकेम सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम इंडिया. ओके, यू कैन रीड दैट. देन डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. नेम थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स दैट द न्यूली इंडिपेंडेंट नेशन ऑफ इंडिया फेस्ड. थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स, चैलेंजेस, प्रिंसली स्टेट्स, पार्टीशन, रिफ्यूजीज. पार्टीशन में हो गया ना, डेवलपमेंट, डायवर्सिटी एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. ओके, देन व्हाट वाज द रोल ऑफ द प्लानिंग कमीशन? द रोल ऑफ द प्लानिंग कमीशन इज टू एग्जीक्यूट द पॉलिसीज एंड टू डिसाइड. where to set up the factories. This I'm just telling you, you can just listen. Later on, I will share the PDF with you, then you can write also. Okay? So then, lastly, to achieve the balance between different regions in the country. So you have to write three purposes of calculation. Fill in the blank. See, subjects that were placed on the union list were dash, dash, and dash. Taxes, defense, and foreign affairs. This you can write down in the book. Taxes, defense, and foreign affairs. B, subjects on the concurrent list were
forest and agriculture.
C, economic planning by which both the state and the private sector played a role in development was called a dash model.
Mixed economy model.
I told you what is mixed economy model, where the state and the private sector worked together. That is called mixed economy model. The death of dash sparked off such violent protests that the government was forced to get into the demand for a linguistic state of Andhra. 40 Okay. Let's see whether true or false. First one, at independence, the majority of Indians lived in villages.
True.
Yes, true. B, the Constituent Assembly was made up of members of the Congress Party.
False.
In the first national election, only men were allowed to vote.
False.
The second 5-year plan focused on the development of heavy industry.
True.
Then four questions are there that we have already discussed. First one is, what did Dr. Ambedkar mean when he said that in politics we have equality, but in social and economic life we will have inequality? That I already explained. One man, one vote, one value. You get that concept will come here. Then after independence, why was there a reluctance to divide the country on linguistic lines? Why did Congress did not fill the promise of giving different states on the basis of language?
Because Pakistan was also
major. Because they were always scared. They have seen so much of bloodshed and riots when the partition of India and Pakistan happened. So that time, that's why they were not ready to give more divisions. Give one reason why English continued to be used in India after independence.
There was
opposition from the southern states. Okay, they felt that English, Hindi should not be imposed on them. How was the economic development of India visualized in the early decades after independence? This will come to the last paragraph which we have discussed, that independent press, independent judiciary, free press, okay, and there was the setting up of heavy industries, concept of 5-year plans. This all will come in this chapter or in this portion. Okay, so that's it. With this, your chapter is complete.